Hey guys, this is Anna with another Figma tip. So today I want to talk about how you can use component properties to build pseudo slot components. In this example, I'm going to be building a card component with some slots that I then want to switch out with some other components. So here is the slot placeholder that I have, and then these are the components that I want to switch it out with. To start building my card, I'm going to create a frame. Let's drop in an instance of the slot placeholder. And let's apply auto layout, and then I'm going to put in just 5 slot placeholders. Then I'll turn it into a component, and then for each slot, I'm going to click on it. And first, I'm going to create a instant swap property so that I can switch this out with other components. I'll just name this slot 1, and I'm going to number each one so it's easy for me to keep track of which slot I'm editing. Then I can now set preferred values. So the ones that are showing up here are already grouped together with the slot placeholder in this frame. But what's really nice about component properties is that I also have the option to swap out this placeholder with components and other libraries that I have access to. But for the sake of the demo, I'm just going to stick to the components that I have in the same file. So I'm going to select all the ones that I want to switch it out with. Click create property, and then I'm also going to go to layer and create a Boolean property because I want to be able to choose which slots I want to show or to change the number of items that I have in my card component. Create property, and yeah, basically I'll follow that step for every single slot, but for the sake of time, let's just fast forward, and this is what it's going to look like once I do that. So here you can see we have our instant swap properties for all 5 slots, as well as the ability to show or hide each of the 5 slots. Now, something else that's really important is for some of these components that I want to switch my slot placeholder with, is that they each have their own corresponding component properties. So for example, this body text that I have is a text component property. Same thing with the header. And then also for this button component, I have a property set up that allows me to switch out which icon is being used, to show or hide the icon, and then also to edit the label text of the button. So in order to surface those properties, what I'm going to do is I'll click on the main card component, click this plus button by properties, and then choose to expose nested instances. And because I have 5, I'm just going to select for all 5. Cool. And now let's see how this works. So I'm going to just drag out an instance of my card component. And to switch out the components used in the slots, I can either edit it from this properties panel here. So yeah, let's add like a header and a divider. But I could also do this at the level of the slot. So I could click on the slot layer itself and switch from there as well. It just kind of depends on what your own personal preference is. So yeah, and let's add some text, and then let's add maybe an action button here. Cool. So this is how you can switch them. And then also because I created Boolean properties, I'm also able to show and hide at the different slots. And you can also see that when I toggle them off, the view to be able to switch it out disappears because it's not applicable since you can't see it. You can't switch it out with another component until it's visible again. I can also edit the number of slots I have just by pressing delete. And then you can see here, it's showing that slot 5 is hidden. Something else to point out is that, so since we do have some components that are switched out with the slot placeholder that have their own properties, is they're going to show up as I'm adding them. So here I can see for the header text, I can edit the title here just from the properties panel. And then I can also change things about the button as well. So maybe I want to hide the icon. And yeah, if I hide slot 5, you can see that the button's no longer visible. And so the action button component properties are hidden. But yeah, that's how you use component properties to create pseudo slot components, and I hope you enjoyed this.